Into the mountain.
Can you see it?
Shall we tell her where to go?
It's not far.
Go on.
Look up. Just up there. Listen to us.
That's it.
Shall we tell her where to go? Shall we?
Does she know which way to look?
Does she know her way into the mountain?
She's a good girl.
Oh, isn't she?
Look up.
So clever.
Did you miss us?
Oh, she did. She did.
We're back.
She's so glad we're back. Go on.
Which way to go?
Go up. Go up. Go up into the mountain.
There's a door.
You can do it.
You can see it.
Come on, Senua.
Go away. I'm not listening.
I will tell you of a great hero named Sigurd, son of Sigmund, no less. Born after his father's death, Sigurd is cared for by the dwarf, Reyn. But Reyn does not love the boy. Instead, he plans to use him for his own ends. You see, Reyn's father possessed a great treasure given to him by the gods. But Reyn's brother, Fafnir, killed his father and took the gold all for himself. Fafnir hid the treasure out on a heath and could not leave it. And from the evil in his heart, he turned into a dark creature. A dragon.
She can feel it.
No.
Don't open the door.
No, go in. Don't open the door.
What's it like?
Get back! A great beast guards Helheim. Garm is its name. And it knows you are here, Senua. It can smell your stink. What are you afraid of, Senua? How would you say Dillion if you are too much of a coward to step into the shadows?
They can't stop me.
Then do it. Sword is useless here.
It's me, Senua.
It's so loud.
It's not her.
So full of hate.
It's a trap.
I just want to help them. Tell me what to do. Your father wants them to go away. And he only hurts me to silence them. But he's gone now.
But they always come back. He says I will die if I go with them.
They say that I'm already dead.
No,
they won't be with them.
Stop!
That's why they crawl through the walls.
Don't
listen. Do you
to them.
See them? Do you see their faces?
He's coming! Senua! Help me! Help! Get me out of here! Don't go!
Where has she gone? She's disappeared again.
She shouldn't be here. She escaped the darkness. She took her own life to escape it.
She can't remember when it started. When her mother lost her smile. Her eyes gazing past her towards a world she could not see. This is what happens if you reach for the underworld, he said. It was a lot to take in for a child. And the first time she felt the cold chill of fear. I don't talk much about her father, Zinbel. I suppose I just didn't want to risk upsetting her. But it doesn't matter now, does it?
Her torch is going out. No, it's not. It's going to run out soon.
She hasn't got much time.
It's going to burn out. She's too slow. It's not going to burn out.
The darkness will come again.
Stay. Have light. Stay, Fido.
Focus! 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 accident. You can't go anywhere without your light.
Take the torch and move.
Lighting the torch. You're not gonna help her.
She's leaving. I need you safe.
To keep the darkness.
Do you think you can keep away from the shadows?
I like the torch. You're wrong. Light burning. You're safe.
You killed us.
She has it.
She did it. She's done it.
Well done.
This place, it reminds her of the isolating, suffocating darkness that she lived through as a young girl. Imprisoned in her room at night, the faces in the dark, coming through the walls. She once thought everyone could see them. I mean, that's what children say all the time, isn't it? There are monsters in the dark. By the time she realized that only she could see them, her father, Zinbel, could see the monster in her.
She'll have to go in.
She can't.
She has to.
She can't.
The torch will go out.
Don't. It's the torch. Go out.
She can do it.
She can't do it.
No. The light's gone out. Run. Run. Get through it as quick as you can. The panic is here.
Rayan the Dwarf's sole desire is to possess this dragon's accursed treasure, and he uses Sigurd to reclaim it. He tells Sigurd the story of Fafnir's gold, and the good-hearted hero promises to slay the dragon if Rayan would forge a strong sword for him. Sigurd remembers that his father once possessed a sword given to him by Odin. Odin broke the sword to bring about Sigmund's death, but Sigurd's mother still has the pieces. And so Rayan reforges the famous sword. Sigurd uses the sword first to avenge his father, and then he and Rayan go in search of Fafnir.
do you feel? The beast is crawling into your mind, searching for weakness. It found your mother and used her to trap you in here.
Did you see her die? I don't remember. I was only 5. They told me she escaped the darkness, that she's with the gods. But what if they lied? What if the darkness took her and trapped her here?
The dragon Fafnir is so large and deadly that it would be impossible to kill him face to face. But each day, Fafnir crawls across the heath to find water. So Sigurd digs a pit in the dragon's path and lies in wait in it. When Fafnir slithers overhead, Sigurd sinks his sword into the dragon up to the hilt. Sigurd leaps from the pit, and Fafnir sees his killer. He warns Sigurd that the treasure will lead to his death, as it led to the death of all who owned it. Sigurd replies that death comes to all men, and every man would want to be wealthy and take the brave. And he takes the treasure.
It's a trap. The beast is coming. It's sleeping beneath me. In the world you pined for Dillion. Do you remember the darkness, Senua? The beast is bringing it back.
Mother, why did you leave me? Spreading. Father's keeping me away from the others. Away from Tilly. I won't give up. I'm not going to rot in here. I'm going to find Dillian.
She knows the beast is there. He's always
watching you.
You're never safe from him.
You can feel him.
Be careful.
She needs to find Dillian. She lost it and she has to find it.
I can feel it.
Is it? Light. The torch, the light.
You're never gonna find
close.
Thank you.
the darkness.
But she wouldn't listen.
And now everybody is dead.
Because of her. It's all her fault.
All her fault. Was
she should have known. She should have thought.
Why doesn't she learn?
Well, she learns. She doesn't understand.
Now the darkness has Dillian Samuel.
And it will take it and never give it back.
She can search and search, but she will never
find it. It's the end.
The darkness will take her like it took her mother.
She can't resist. Pointless even trying to...
Although Sigurd kills the dragon, Rian wants to keep Fafnir's gold all for himself. Rian also wants the strength and wisdom of the dragon, so he drinks its blood and asks Sigurd to roast Fafnir's heart for him. Sigurd does so, but when he touches the roasted heart to see if it is done, he burns his finger. Without thinking, he licks his finger and tastes the dragon's blood. In that moment, he understands the language of birds and hears them talk nearby.
The darkness will take her like it took her mother.
The beast knows. The beast knows exactly where she is.
She's falling for it.
She falls for their tricks every time.
Please.
Sigurd's newfound power lets him hear the birds speak, and they say, Sigurd should eat the heart himself. Rian wants Fafnir's gold. Sigurd should kill Rian before Rian kills him. Sigurd should find Brynhild the Valkyrie, who sleeps an enchanted sleep. Sigurd heeds the bird's advice. He kills Rian, eats Fafnir's roasted heart, and takes Fafnir's treasure. And he embarks on a new quest. To ride to Hinderfell and find Brynhild, the Valkyrie.
Yes.
and then quick.
Keep going, keep going. What is she doing?
Stop!
Stop! Stop! Keep going! Stop letting me know.
And then quick.
Help but think of him. A tender guiding flame in a world so black. The longer it burned, the more she convinced herself that there was nothing beyond its reach. How little separates us from what we fear.
She has to. Keep the torch alight.
Sigurd learns that Brynhild had once disobeyed Odin, and so he had her punished. Stuck her with a sleep thorn and put her body within a rampart of burning shields. Only a man who knew no fear would ever reach her. But like me, Sigurd is fearless and passes through the flames, just as I did, and wakes the sleeping warrior girl. She teaches him the secret wisdom of runes, namely victory runes, ship runes, runes for persuasion, runes for truth, runes for healing and help, runes for perception and power. Like Sigurd, the greatest young warrior of the North, you must learn the secrets of the runes to fight amongst the gods in hell.
Shadow. breathing darkness!
Thank you.
People think of evil as an unnatural, invisible force, and so invoke the gods for protection. But evil can come from the hand behind the gods. A familiar hand, cold and cruel. He tried to fix her with his rituals, kept her trapped in that hole. She couldn't say which was worse, the darkness, or the monster that her father had become. She couldn't fight them both. And so she left, headed for the one ray of light that shone down on her. If she had stayed, she wouldn't have survived. But maybe Delian would still be alive.
I am so sorry, my love.
She will save his soul, even if this time she can't save her own.
Forgive me, Senua. I know you have no reason to trust me anymore.
Shadow, listen.
But believe this. It was my mission to make you hate. To hate the darkness with a passion so great it would focus your mind on this quest. For without it, I feel like there is black. All this time, I wanted to protect you from the truth that would have destroyed you a long time ago. But you have conquered your darkness at every turn. You deserve to see behind the veil of darkness.
Then take me to the mountain to trust you. As deep as we can go.
I won't stand in your way.
She has to trust him.
You will not survive what is in there.
I know.
What else can she do?
She doesn't want to die. Gaze, searching for secrets inside of me. Secrets that even I can't see. I'm not here to fight my past. I'm here for Delian. I will fulfill my vow, whatever the cost.
People will forget what they owe their kindred. Times will be hard. Crimes will be great. It will be an age of axes and swords. The wind will blow through abandoned halls. Wolves will walk where children played. The world will fall into ruin.
Delian.
finish it. She's injured. She can still eat. You won't defeat. You can do this. Focus. Focus now.
This isn't just a broken bridge, is it? Mother, you showed me how to see further. To see the hidden wonders in our world and explore new paths into the unknown. To lead so that others may follow, or to warn so that they may avoid. That is our gift and our duty. I'm not going to look away in fear anymore.
The Northmen say the gods will fight their last battle at Ragnarok. Their watchmen will blow the horn that can be heard through the whole world. And Odin will speak with the severed head of Mimir, which gives him good counsel. The land of the giants will thunder with the sound of their army on the move. The gods will assemble. The dwarves will leave their stones. The frost giants will come from the east. The Midgard serpent will turn up the waves. Eagles will scream and tear at the corpses with their yellow beaks. The ship of the dead will set sail.
She can do it.
She can do it.
She has the sight. She can see.
There's a way.
She can see it. She must align herself.
She can do it.
There's the door.
She aligns herself. It's there.
The Northmen say that at Ragnarok, the gods will face a ship full of their foes, which Loki has steered to Asgard. It carries the fire giants, the wolf that will eat the sun, and all kinds of dark creatures. Surt will join them with his sword of fire. The cliffs will crash, trolls will walk the land, men will tread the road to hell, and the heavens will split open.
Thank you.
Odin will fight the monstrous wolf and be killed, but his son will avenge him and plunge his sword into the heart of the beast. Freyr will face Surt, but he had given his sword away for naught, and without it, he cannot defend himself against the flames. Thor will smite the Midgard serpent to no avail. The sun will grow black, the earth will sink into the sea, the stars will disappear, fire and water will meet, steam will shoot up, flames will play against the sky, the heavens and earth and all the world will be burned, all the gods will be dead, and the warriors of Valhalla and the people everywhere. Senua, prepare yourself for Ragnarok. For it is nigh.
We'll all die someday.
I don't want to die.
And when everyone's gone, even the gods will die.
We don't want to die.
Stop. I don't want to die.
Senua.
Stop.
Senua. Turn back.
Stop. Stop her.
Turn around.
Why is she going? Stop.
Senua.
Stop.
Why would she stop to die? She won't stop. 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 Stop.
I'm sorry. I didn't ask you to be a part of me. If you don't want to die with me, then leave me alone.
Stop. I don't want to die. Please stop. Please stop. Please stop. Please stop. Please stop. Please stop. Please stop.
You'll never come back if you go there.
There is nothing to go back to.
We only have each other now. Don't abandon me.
Everyone suffers. They were right about me.
Then, listen to me. Not them. They are afraid. Like children scared of the dark.
So was I.
They made up monsters to fill the void. That doesn't make them real.
In search of victory and honor. Clear dividing lines. No. Oh, this place is not quite like that. It's as if it knows that true torment lies within. Memories you cannot defeat, cannot escape. This is her hell.
There's nothing to fear anymore. The gods have saved your mother. Through my hands.
You killed her.
It is the will of the gods.
Fuck the gods! You did this to her! Why?
This is what happens when you listen to the voices of the underworld. They crawl into your soul and rot you from the inside. Defy the gods like your mother, and the darkness will come for you too. You understand, son?
your own madness. I was just a child. You created this darkness! You created this darkness so you could hide behind it!
Only suffering brings salvation. It is the way of the gods.
It was all a lie. You are alive! She didn't defy the gods. She defied you. And so you killed her.
You didn't pray to the gods. You prayed to your mother. Your mother, who was too weak to fight the darkness and abandoned you.
You tortured her. You killed her. You are the darkness.
Of isolation, the pain that still haunts you. It was the only way to fight the curse within you.
You're a liar.
The darkness is inside you and it will destroy you.
You're a liar!
No, Senua. The darkness is here. You cannot wish it away. And it will watch as you draw your last dying gasp.
I won't let you kill me!
Watch out.
darkness. You're a liar and a murderer. And if you really are Hela, then I have a sword here that can kill a god.
Look at you. Running forward and moving backwards to worry your miserable past. You're making a mistake searching for Dillion. The same mistake that killed him in the first place. I'm trying to save you from yourself. You said that it is a lie. The plague of darkness, the butchering of Dillion by the Northmen. You saw it yourself.
You told everyone I was cursed. They believed you. I believed you.
Tell me, Senua, where is Dillion's soul if the darkness is a lie? How you saved him?
He's here. I know he's here. Dillion, I know you're here. Hold on. I'll find you. Again with your lies. I know he's here. You took him from me. You have him.
Dillion is gone. Dillion is dead. Let him go.
Behind you.
Or what? What can he do to me that you haven't already?
He betrayed.
betrayed
Fight
your
me.
Own father.
Uchama.
You betrayed the gods in search of Billia, in search of love. Look where that's
Behind
got you.
You.
Let go of your battle. Let go of your demigod. Let go of Dillia.
Behind you.
Don't let your darkness hurt anyone else.
You want me to believe? After all you've done to me? And to him? You're not a lie, but you're a liar! You crawled into me to confuse me and deceive me.
I know you have him. No power over me.
I learned the hard way to not be afraid of death, Senna. Because a life without loss is one without love. You turn your back on death, and all you can see is the shadow that it casts. The longer you hide from it, the longer the shadow grows until all you can see is darkness. When our time comes, we must look death in the eye and embrace it as a friend. Only then can we let go of our fear. And emerge from our darkness.
Thank you. Never forget what it is like to see the world as a child, Senua. Every autumn leaf is like a work of art. Every rolling cloud a moving picture. Every day, a new story. We too emerge from this magic, like a wave from the ocean. Only to return to the sea. Do not mourn the waves, the leaves, and the clouds. Even in darkness, the wonder and the beauty of this world never leaves us. It is always there, waiting to be seen again.
This is where my story once began. And so it has to end here. Because I cannot see further than this.
Follow us. We have another story to tell.
My friend, go with her. This now will be your story to witness.
Change you. Please don't go. I want you to stay. I'm begging you, please. Please don't leave here. I don't want you to hate. For all the hurt that you feel, the world is just illusion, trying to change you. Please don't go. I want you to stay. I'm begging you, please. Oh, please don't leave.